There are so many inventions today that it is hard to keep track of what is performing well and what is not. And in the world of well-performing planes, it is rare to see an invention that pushes design performance so far ahead that all the planes that came before it seem like children's toys in comparison. There is one plane that blew all the others out of the water. We are talking about the SR-71. It is the fastest operational aircraft ever that travels faster than 3 times the speed of sound. A creation of the US government, they gladly put time into this machine to create a surveillance aircraft that could soar to heights where the Earth's curvature is visible, a sight usually reserved for astronauts. Today we discuss the history, design, and capabilities of one of the most iconic and legendary planes ever built, the SR-71 Blackbird. The Blackbird was an incredible feat of engineering and is a marvel of aviation to this day. So let's rewind back in time and learn the story. In 1957, the Soviet Union developed intercontinental ballistic missiles in mass production. Why, you ask? Fear. The fear of a direct nuclear strike on American cities by the Soviet. It drove them to prioritize intelligence collection of the Soviet Union's nuclear arsenal. The US was unable to achieve this using mere conventional aircraft. America required surveillance planes that were difficult for radar devices to spot and could not be destroyed by missiles. The CIA asked Lockheed Martin's Skunk Works Division, led by Kelly Johnson, to develop a secret spy in the sky for this mission, and they named it Project Archangel. The vision was to have this spy aircraft fly so high and fast that the Soviets' radars could never detect it. After Air Force Major Rudolf Anderson was killed while flying a U-2 reconnaissance mission over Cuba on October 27, 1962, during the height of the Cuban Missile Crisis, there was growing pressure to put the Blackbird into service. Skunk Works responded diligently, and by 1964, they had successfully created a top-secret aircraft that could revolutionize the world of aviation and intelligence gathering. It was the SR-71 Blackbird, the fastest and highest-flying manned aircraft ever built. It could operate at speeds of up to Mach 3.2, about 3 times faster than the speed of sound, and reach altitudes of over 85,000 feet. This meant it could operate at the edge of space and outrun any enemy missiles or fighters. To put it simply, you could fly from New York to London in just under 2 hours with this bad boy. 50 years after it was built, the SR-71 was still the world's fastest air-breathing manned aircraft, previously held by the related Lockheed YF-12. The first flight of the SR-71 Blackbird took place in 1964, after which it entered service with the United States Air Force in 1966. The Blackbird gained fame for its incredible speed and altitude capabilities. It was regarded as one of the most advanced and secretive planes in the world, and played a crucial role in monitoring the military activities of the Soviet Union during the Cold War. For something that was not incremental, it fundamentally changed not only how we thought about collecting reconnaissance, but also what we knew at the time about aerospace design and aerospace dynamics. Sean Roche, Associate Deputy Director for Digital Innovation at the CIA. It was mandatory that the SR-71 Blackbird have a stealthy design. Given that the aircraft's leading edges were predicted to reach temperatures of more than 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit, the extreme heat presented several issues during the design process. It rendered the choice of material and design almost powerless. A titanium alloy was the only material that could be used for the airframe, because it provided the strength of stainless steel, a relatively low weight, and resistance to high temperatures. But it turned out that titanium is a very delicate material to construct an airplane. The brittle alloy can shatter if mishandled. This was a source of great frustration at the Skunk Works assembly line and new training classes for Lockheed's machinists. The aircraft's characteristic black hue was a result of the material, and it soon earned its name, Blackbird. The Russians never had an inkling on how they were contributing to the creation of the aircraft being rushed into construction to spy on their homeland, said Ben Rich, Lockheed's chief aerodynamicist for the SR-7. The Soviet Union was the primary source and leading titanium exporter at that time. The CIA managed to purchase the base metal from the Soviet Union using third parties and dummy companies, a sneaky move. They were buying from the enemy to defeat the enemy, masterminds. In addition to creating a material for the plane that could withstand extremely high temperatures caused by airflow friction at high speeds, the technical team also had to create an engine that could deliver the required thrust. The aircraft was powered by two Pratt & Whitney J58 engines that were capable of producing a total of 160,000 horsepower. Impressive. Everything had to be invented. Everything, Johnson recalled. The Pratt & Whitney J58 turbojet engines required a particularly low-volatility fuel known as JP7. It was essential to use because the titanium skin of the SR71 became so hot that it put regular fuel at risk of igniting. The engines had to use a unique variable cycle system that allowed them to switch between a turbojet and a ramjet, depending on the altitude and speed of the aircraft. The power of these engines was outrageous since they consumed their weight in fuel in a matter of minutes. To add to that, the Lockheed Skunk Works division had to invent ingenious methods to manufacture the Blackbird. One solution was to build it with big gaps in its structure. This prevented cracking due to metal expansion when overheated, but the gaps allowed fuel to leak onto the runway often. Its design was just a puzzle. The Blackbird was a marvel of a machine with a length of 107 feet, a wingspan of 55 feet, and a height of 18 feet. A pilot and a reconnaissance systems officer were the ones to operate the aircraft, but the seating area was not ideal. The cockpit area of the plane was cramped and required the pilots to wear a full pressure suit due to the high altitudes at which the plane flew. Fortunately, the instrumentation in the cockpit was state-of-the-art, including a radar warning receiver, an infrared search and track system, and a defensive electronic countermeasures system. One of the most innovative features of the Blackbird was its unique shape. It was truly a marvel in the air. The Blackbird's design made it look like a spaceship. The aircraft was designed with a slender, streamlined shape that helped reduce drag and improve performance at high speeds, while its pointed nose and sharply angled wings helped it cut through the air and minimize radar reflection easily. Its distinctive pointed nose also housed a complex array of sensors and cameras that could capture images from distances up to 100 miles away. The Blackbird was so insanely fast and maneuverable that once it detected incoming missiles, it would speed up and evade them. Its main defense tactic was its speed, while its altitude capabilities allowed it to fly above 95% of the Earth's atmosphere, making it nearly impossible to detect. The Blackbird was equipped with advanced sensors and cameras, allowing it to capture high-resolution images of enemy targets from extreme distances. The aircraft was also equipped with a range of electronic warfare systems, which allowed it to jam enemy radar and communication systems. One of the most notable missions undertaken by the SR-71 Blackbird was Operation Senior Crown, which took place during the Vietnam War. The mission involved flying over North Vietnam to gather intelligence on enemy military activity. It was able to fly over the heavily defended airspace during the mission without being detected, while gathering intelligence that was critical to the success of the war effort. The Blackbird was not invulnerable, despite its advanced technology, incredible speed, and altitude capabilities. The aircraft was often tracked by Soviet radar and was occasionally targeted by missiles, but never shot down. That deserves some respect. The aircraft was difficult to fly and maintain, and several people were lost throughout its operational life. However, the bravery and skill of the pilots who flew the Blackbird made it one of the most successful and valuable aircrafts in history. The SR-71 Blackbird was retired from service in 1998 due to budget cuts and the development of unmanned reconnaissance drones. To honor its life, today several Blackbirds are displayed in museums across the United States, including the Smithsonian National Air and Space Museum in Washington, D.C. Just roughly 20 years after World War II, the United States Air Force had gradually upgraded from propeller planes to the SR-71 Blackbird. The aircraft is an incredible achievement in aviation engineering and remains one of the most legendary planes ever built. Its legacy lives on, and it continues to inspire generations of engineers and aviation enthusiasts. But what good is a jet without a runway to take off? That's where aircraft carriers come in. Check out our video to learn some truly mind-blowing facts about the multi-billion-dollar monsters of the seas.